Hello, welcome to Automate with UiPath. I'm creating a series of videos to help people who don't understand API and its usage with UiPath, because one of the interview questions that normally be asked is how will you use UiPath with APIs so that you can get the data, because it's not only important to automate any legacy application with UiPath UI automation activities, it's also equally important to understand how can you integrate the legacy application with the latest data APIs. So that's how we are going to, or that's what we are going to learn in this particular training series. And this will be a three-part training series. So I have recently posted a video on top three APIs that I normally use, and I recommend everyone to learn with these, because this will be easier. And first video will be using random user .me API, and the second one with FDA government, and the third one with NASA government API. So the complexity will be increased after each session. So let's start this session with random user API. So how can we get data from an API? If there is a website or if there is a web application, well, what you are seeing on a web browser is a UI, from where you can view it or you can visualize it. But when you go behind, or when you see how the data is retrieved from a database, or how exactly are we getting data, it will not be with the UI, but it will be just the data. Let's go to a web browser and let's add the URL randomuser.me/API. So if you see here, we got data. So this is how we will receive the data, and this data will be represented in the form of UI. But for now, we'll see how can we read this data and how can we manipulate this data and how can we extract whatever relevant fields are available that are required for us. That's what we are going to see. So for easy understanding and to view it properly, I am going to add everything in my Notepad++, and I do have a plugin, JSON viewer. So I'm just trying to view everything in JSON. So plugins, JSON viewer, format JSON. So if you see, there is square bracket here and there is a flower bracket here. So what is the difference and how exactly do we need to read and everything? Let's go ahead and understand. If you haven't subscribed yet to the channel, go ahead and please subscribe, because next all the videos will be conceptually very good. And if you have any queries that I need to make videos on, please go ahead and comment. Let's see what exactly do we have in the data or JSON. Each and every JSON will start for sure with a flower bracket, and it will end with a flower bracket. Okay, and there are only two things that can be available in a JSON. One is either an object, the second one, it can be an array. Let's understand few concepts. Let's understand few rules of JSON. So the data should always be in name value pairs. So there should be a key. If you understand a dictionary, if you see a dictionary, how a dictionary will be there? A dictionary contains a name or a word and followed by its meaning. In the same way, each and every data should be represented in the form of a key and a value. Data should be separated by commas. If you want to represent multiple keys or multiple data, it should be represented with a comma. So in this representation, if you see, there is key and a value, and comma and key to and value. Every object should be held by a curly bracket. So if you see here, I have written this in normal brace, but we always need to mention any kind of JSON in form of a curly bracket or a flower bracket. Now, if you want to add, or if you want to add any array of data, for example, here I want to represent fruits, but I cannot represent one fruit by mentioning it as fruits. So to do that, I will give fruits as a key, and if you see, I have written things, or I have written all the fruit names in a square bracket. So again, the basic representation of array states that every item should be separated with a comma. So in the same way, we are representing all the items like apple, banana and mango with commas, and the last item should not have a comma. So that's how you need to understand, and these are the four rules of JSON. Well, if you don't understand, that's absolutely fine. in the next few minutes, you will definitely understand what I meant to say. So here I am writing, or I have a simple JSON here. So even this is a JSON. So what this JSON indicates? This JSON indicates about a particular book, and that book ID is 110 and the language is Python and price is 1900. So if I want to add one more book, I can add it in the next object. So I can add it like this, and I need to represent everything in separate curly brace. So all this data is related to books, but in that I have data related to Python and I have data related to C#. Let's assume that these are two books. So if you see, each and every key is represented with a value. But what if I want to add multiple array of items? So this is how it goes. A JSON with array of objects is called as a JArray. And here, if you see, ebook is the key. And after ebook, we are having multiple objects. So these multiple objects are represented in the form of square bracket. And these square brackets contains all the objects. And if you see the structure, each and every item has a same structure. Language and edition are the common items or the common keys for each and every value or each and every item. But the values of language and edition are changing for each and every object. The next part of this video, where we are trying to extract, or where we will be trying to add what are the activities that we require, to what are the activities that we need to download to work with JSON, and how can we get the values directly from a text file, and how can we get a value directly from the website or directly from an API call. Check the link in the description for the next part.